sorrow, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can't survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you. It's a long road, and you face the world alone. One reaches out ahead for you to hold. You can find love if you search within yourself, and the emptiness you felt will disappear. And then a hero comes
be nobleness. when I was in school, we used to sing it something like this. Listen here. Oh, beautiful, far spacious skies, far amber waves of grain, far purple mountain majesties. Now wait a minute, I'm talking about America, sweet America. You know, God done shed his grace on thee. He crowned thy good. Yes, he did. Heavy brotherhood. Sing this.
America,
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 I love you, America. You see, my God, he done shed his face on thee. You ought to love him for it, cause he crowned my good. He told me he would, every brotherhood.
Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. Everybody knows your name. You wanna go where people know. People are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Master Sergeant Nathaniel Wilcox Sr. from the Space and Missile Systems Center, Launch Enterprise Directory, Los Angeles Air Force Base, California. It's my great pleasure to welcome you to the third annual celebration of the Tuskegee Airmen Day in California. In addition to the original Tuskegee Airmen, Francis Ashford. Reginald Ballard. Lumpkin. Mr. Henry Polite. And Mr. Robert Taylor. Yeah. Also not in attendance with us today due to weather, Mr. Levi Thornhill. Yeah. And Mr. Edward Tillman. We also have guests in the audience from Los Angeles chapter of Tuskegee Airmen, Munford Marines, and the Los Angeles Air Force Base. We would like to thank the Talashe family for providing the use of the newly reopened Proud Bird restaurant. Welcome and thank you for celebrating with us. To start things off, we have the incomparable Virgil Murray from Lancaster to share with us his beautiful gift of gospel mind. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present Mr. Virgil Murray.
Thank you. Yes, he is.
Airmen. We're here to celebrate the vital role that Tuskegee Airmen maintained in the service, department, and progress of America throughout our history. In spite of adversity and limited opportunities, these Americans have played a significant role in U.S. military history over the past 300 years. They were denied military leadership roles and skilled training because of the color of their skin and the mistaken belief that they lacked what it took for combat duty. While other soldiers fought in a singular battle against an external enemy, their fight was dual for a double victory. Victory over enemies from without and victory over enemies from within. The right to participate in the defense of our nation and the right to participate in everyday society as equal citizens. Before 1940, black people were barred from flying for the U.S. military. Civil rights organizations and black press exerted pressure that resulted in the formation of an all-black pursuit squadron based in Tuskegee, Alabama in 1941. They became known as the Tuskegee Airmen. The Tuskegee Airmen overcame segregation and prejudice to become one of the most highly respected fighter groups of World War II. They proved conclusively that they could fly and maintain sophisticated combat aircraft. The Tuskegee Airmen's achievements, together with men and women who supported them, paved the way for a full integration of U.S. military. There are chapters across the country that keep the Tuskegee Airmen legacy alive through the education of our youth. With 80 members, the Los Angeles chapter is the largest nationally and includes 12 documented original Tuskegee Airmen. This chapter provides speakers and school events, films, books, and scholarships for local students. Thank you for keeping the legacy alive. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to introduce Lieutenant Colonel Ted Lumpkin, who served as a military intelligence officer as a Tuskegee Airman.
So good morning.
Good morning.
It might even be noontime now. And so I'll get started. The good thing that I think we can say is that the my introduction was my speech. So about what it is that I have to say. But one little thing about that is this day is a grounds up activity or action. We have the DOTAs here. You know the DOTAs are the Documented Original Tuskegee Airmen. And we are on our way out. As you can see, most of us have gray hair. And most of us are a little bit around the century mark. No, I think some of maybe you should say the 80 and 90 century a mark. But the thing that happened at our convention, we have conventions each year, the Tuskegee Airmen. I think it was around 2012 when we had a resolution that came up to the convention regarding having a Tuskegee Airmen commemorative day. And I don't know why it was not actually 100% adopted. Maybe it was because a DOTA did not present it. It was a younger man who was involved with war in Korea, etc. Dave Tolliver out of Arizona. He's about 10 or 15 years younger than most DOTAs. And he proposed to have that day, but it was a lukewarm reception and they did not actually adopt it. But they did encourage him to go to his state and get it adopted. Through his work, they did. The state of Arizona adopted Tuskegee Airmen Commemorative Day in 2014. And they are now at Luke Air Force Base, probably at this very moment, celebrating their fifth one. They inspired members of the LA chapter, once they really knew about it, to get involved. And for one reason or another, we had the chapter members and the committees was one of the century that I was born in. And it gets to be automatic. But where was I? Okay, so they did adopt that, and our chapter members were interested in getting it done too. So we had our chairperson, our Simeon Ginyard, and Mr. Simeon right here. And Jocelyn Tomlin. Was a committee chair. They were co-chairs at that time.
And that's the reason.
And now she is the president of the LA chapter. And as you can see, the LA chapter is moving along and is alive and is up to date with the times. The Me Too movement is here before you know it, or before you knew it. All right, but in, what was the date? Let me get my...
March 16, 2016,
the California Assembly, the California Legislature adopted the Tuskegee Airmen Day. It included the commemoration of the day. Those words were there, but it was not really emphasized as much as I think it should be, because that's the thing that it is. It's not a holiday. Memorial Day is a holiday that is celebrated for those of us who, or those who were not able to come out of the wars alive. And the second, November the 11th, is the day of Veterans Day, which really celebrates everything that's involved as far as the military is concerned in this country. So what we want to do is to do what we're doing here today. That this is the, we're memorializing the Tuskegee Airmen experience and the impact that it has had on this country. I think it has been tremendous, and to see this room. It started out, and when I came in this morning, I said, oh, this is going to be a nice little gathering, and we can have an exchange of conversation, and everybody will be pleased. But to have a full room like this, and having to talk, to be able to see all the way back to the room there, it's really wonderful. And I want each of you to be a helper in making this day a big day. It's actually more than a holiday. To have a commemorative day is something, you know, we're serious. We really is a thing that you take to heart. And let all of your friends know that this day has occurred, and that it's going to occur each and every year in the state of California, in the state of Arizona. They're working on it in Colorado. They're working on it in Maryland. In fact, they were to have a big celebration in Maryland today, but they had to cancel it because of the severe weather that's there. We didn't cancel ours. So when we talk about California rain compared to the storms that are occurring in the East Coast, we can well understand why they had to cancel their particular day. I'm not going to say much else, but to thank you for being here, to thank the Proud Bird for helping us to be involved, and to really participate in this celebration in the way that they have. The Talashays who own this, we have one Talashe here. You know, this is a renowned location for our community, and I think it is wonderful that they were able to keep this facility here and to improve it and to have us here to celebrate this particular, this will be the third annual Tuskegee Airmen Day. So thank you very much.
Before we continue and go further in our program, I'd like to bring up Michelle. Can you come up here, Michelle Goddess? She is the one that spearheaded this program. And I'll just her backbone, I'll just her. But this lady here is an awesome lady, and I can see that her fellow working people are here to support her. And Michelle, you know, you have to say a few words. You got to say a few words.
I'd just like to thank everyone for coming. I'd especially like to thank these heroes. They're my heroes. I'm retired Air Force. I know they're all of ours. And that we hope that out of this celebration that you celebrate Tuskegee Airmen Day every March, every fourth and last Thursday of March. It's important. It's important to keep legacy alive. They're heroes to all of us. Thank you.
Is the mayor of North Uganda, is she still here? Wait, this is the mayor of North Uganda. I want to thank you for coming out. The mayor. The female president of the Tuskegee Airmen, you know, Jonathan Tomlin. And one other very special person here that really was spearheaded in writing this resolution for this project. Dr. Lester Reeves, can you come out and just raise your hand? Dr. Lester Reeves. Amen. I did such an okay with an owner. Said, I asked him if we go over a little bit, it's okay. He said, take as much time as you want. So, this man is an awesome man. And he's a God-fearing man, too. And play a mean bass guitar, too. But this man and Dr. William Upton really spearheaded the writing up the resolution that he was for the assembly to get it passed. The Congress, the governor signed it, everybody signed it, everybody voted for the program. And,
it was an honor doing this. I want to thank Assemblywoman Autumn Burke for all the help that she went through, so let's give her a hand. And sometimes projects become more than just you, and it was a blessing to be part of a wonderful team and committee that this man was part of, and also to honor these heroes over the years. Now, when we went up here, here's a very quick joke. When we were flying back, one person mentioned that, or the flight attendant said, oh, we have a guest here, we have the Tuskegee Airmen. And then a person turned to me and says, my goodness, you look very good for your age. So I pointed them directly to Lieutenant Colonel Ted Lumpkin and said, I think that's your hero. But with all that, bless you all and have a wonderful day.
Stand up. All the members of the Law Standards Chapter can give stand up. You are the members of the, and I want to say thank you so much. Gretchen Burns and Harlan Leonard, he come from Palm Spring area. Harlan Leonard come from Riverside area. They come out, they came a long way in the rain. So, I mean, thank you so much, Rusty and Harlan, for coming out. Thank you for coming out.
I can't tell you how excited I am. I just want to, I'm always full of tears when it comes to the Tuskegee Airmen.
I think you can tell us to sit down.
Oh, you can sit down. I want to introduce, or just talk about the one person that encouraged me to join the chapter. I joined the chapter in 1994. And Rusty, my very good friend, we need you. And I said, no! I came to a meeting, and then I got very active, and I'm really happy that I stayed. And these are my guys, the Tuskegee Airmen, and they're in my heart.
Also, too, we meet every third Friday of the month on Crenshaw and Stocker at the DWP building here in Los Angeles. 6:30. Please, we'd like you to come out, sit in with us, join our chapter. We can use all support of people, corporations, businesses, be part of this legacy, because these men are so great. They are so great.
Yeah.
And it's an honor to work with these guys. Sad to say, one of our men had an episode of the night. We were together Wednesday night. D.Y. Thornhill, he's in the hospital, but he's going to be okay. Dr. Hearn from Lancaster, thank you for coming out. Bill, come here, Bill. Come here. Thank you. Thank you.
I just want to say thank you to every one of you who came today. This was an amazing turnout, a lot more than I expected, and I think for our restaurant to be honored with this kind of a celebration to bring the memory. My father was a veteran, he flew B-17s, so thanks for helping to protect him. But certainly this was a great thing. All the different people, I got to really thank you. I think, you know, if you hadn't gotten me involved, it wouldn't have been as much fun for me. So thank you. I appreciate you being here.
Thank you, Los Angeles Chapter. Thank you, Colonel Lumpkin. We appreciate you taking the time to share your story with us today. In closing, I would like to invite you to meet the original Tuskegee Airmen. They will be sitting in different locations throughout the restaurant. Feel free to introduce yourself, ask questions, and take photos. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. The Proud Bird also has a delicious array of food for purchase. Please take time to enjoy. If you would like information about the Tuskegee Airmen Los Angeles Chapter, or would like to purchase memorabilia, please see the ladies near the window here.
Which window?
This far window, facing the airport. In closing, the living owe it to those who no longer can speak and tell their story. Let's celebrate the Tuskegee Airmen Day every fourth Thursday of March. Celebrate these heroes in your schools, in your work, and at home. Thank you for coming, and have a terrific Tuskegee Airmen Day. Excuse me, one last thing. If everyone could stay in their place to allow the airmen to get to their desired location, so we can meet and greet. Thank you.
My name is Simeon B. Ginyard, and here I have Airman Carlin Leonard. Carlin, tell me, how do you feel about this day for California honoring?
And it's a wonderful thing to target the restaurant for the state to know it's safe. And I have occasionally visited high schools from time to time, and it's
it's great to be here. We're trying to encourage these high school kids to take our scholarship, and anything that we can say that to us more credit this year makes them more enthusiastic. So this will help the scholarship.
Well, you all know that you served your country with dignity, and diligence. And well, I want to say thank you so very much for being part of all this year.
Thank you for the recognition.
Okey-dokey. All right.
Now, which one is it?
Right here.
All right.
He also helped build airplanes in the Navy base. Engineering.
Where was it from originally?
Pennsylvania. And he had three brothers, Marine and the Navy. And it's really funny, sir. I have to mention this. Yeah, the brother thought he was bad. He worked for the railroad, and he was going to beat his boss, so he had a choice to go to the military or go to jail. So he went to the Marine.
What was his name?
Henry. This gentleman here, I forgot his name, but he's still living also in Philadelphia.
Here we got Mr. Rusty Burns. And Rusty Burns was his engineer, and when he got out of service, what he did was start a flying school out there at the Compton Airport. Tell me, what did this day mean to you?
Well, it is recollection of all of the history, the things that have passed, bringing it back to light. You know, this is like 79 years. The Tuskegee Airmen experience started in 39, so it's a culmination of a lot of years, and all the people who were involved in it who are no longer with us, I think about that too. But being here today was important because I haven't been able to get with the group for a number of years because I live so far away.
Yeah.
So thanks to Marshall, I'm here today.
Marshall, thank you so much, because I know you, we talked the other day. And we wasn't sure whether he was going to come or not. Because his wife was saying, I don't know. He was saying, I don't know.
I wouldn't have made it.
And I know that, and thank you know, for making it happen. So
I know I would not have made it.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you for keeping me posted.
You're my man. A long distance man. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
And this is my main man, Mr. Francis Castro. I believe in California. Adam Kip Carey. He's going to be one of our presidents here, so get that right. He's going to be president. Adam Kip, if you see this, as we all know, that you're going to be president. But one day, I'm going to vote for you. Mr. Harris, tell me, what does the day mean to you for having this every day?
This is astounding. The number of people who remember us, who think about us, is really impressive.
This is Ms. Barbara Stewart, and she's a very supportive and real good close personal friend of mine, and she always supports the Tuskegee Airmen all the time. And making this day possible, the 12th Thursday of March, Tuskegee Airmen Day, and you being here today to Proud Bird, what does it mean to you?
Well, it's a historical moment for me. I mean, I've never heard about these guys before, I guess, the 21st century. And I'm just here to meet some of them today. Mr. Lufkin is my favorite. And you're my favorite, too. I taught him how to ballroom.
Yeah, I'm a, you know, we're ballroom dancing.
Thank you, Simeon, for what you do. You're an amazing man. Thank you.
Jerry, how you doing, Jerry? We live on camera. What did you say?
mean to you as far as the state of California, and now that being the fourth Thursday of March, Tuskegee Airmen, what does it really mean to you?
Okay. I'm really proud of the state of California for this big night.
And if y'all didn't know, Mr. Hodges was a bomber. He was a pilot. A B-25 bomber pilot, you know, and twin engine, big twin engine. That was one step lower than the B-17, right? So he served his country diligently, and we're so proud of your service, Jerry. And I'm gonna say thank you. I'm glad I know you. I'm just glad I know you. All right, thank you very much, Jerry. Mr. Wilcox, he was our MC. By you being in the Air Force, what does this day mean to you?
It's important that this day means everything. I originally joined the Air Force because my granddad was an aircraft mechanic, a little bit after the Airmen. But I mean, growing up, telling me a lot of the stories and just how proud it is to be an African American in the United States Service.
And this man did a great job being the MC. I know this was kind of a lasting thing. But you did a hell of a job, a beautiful job. And I just want to say thank you so much for doing what you're doing. And making it real.
Thank you.
Keeping it real. All right, thank you so much. Thank you. This is Neil Robinson. He was one of our past presidents. Los Angeles captain. Always keep me in check. When I get out of line, they know how to pull me back. But I said, you, I'm not giving up. My heart is.
We know where your heart is, no matter what. So you don't need to be pulled back in. What you need to do is we keep you going the way that we want. So that's fantastic.
Okay. Okay, well, thank you so very much, Bill. Thank you for watching.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. This is Bill Tennessee. His father, David Tennessee, is going to Proud Bird here. And he's in the B-17 bomber pilot. And the red tail escorted him a lot of mischief. But, and thank God that he had a red tail that is like a bat, because you wouldn't be here right now.
No.
Yeah, I can say that. So, Bill, I want to say thank you so very much for hosting here at the Proud Bird, you know, the historical Proud Bird, you know. So, it means a lot to you guys coming here to be part of the program. And how do you feel about today's event?
Today's event was great. A lot better than I think we expected. A lot more people than we expected. And something to really look forward to for next year. Really, it's great. I can't say anything. You're awesome.
Thank you very much, Bill. So, that being said, thank you.
Thank you. Everybody have fun.
Dr. Prince, Reverend Prince, come here. This is Reverend Prince, and he was very influential
and keeping the Proud Bird open. This man, very, you know, he went through a whole lot, Reverend, to stay in the community. This man is a community person. And I want to say thank you. And I want to say, how do you feel about today's event?
It was fantastic. Again, the move of God. And I do believe God is in the mix here at the Proud Bird. Keep the history here that is so important that our young children be able to come and get exposed to the history that's here of the Tuskegee Airmen. And thanks to the Celebrant family that has been a blessing to our community. They fought a good fight in order to keep the history of the Tuskegee Airmen. And this day is a great day, and it will continue.
You know what? You know, it's so funny that you hear Bill, because if you know, listen to the time this place has opened back up again, how vibrant things have happened. People are bringing ballrooms out left and right. Always something going on here. So it tells you, let you know that something's right. And things that aren't right, it will get better. As long as the right people in place, you know. I'm so proud to be here. Like, when the weather clears up, come here on Sundays. I'm a tour host here. I was trained and certified by Bill here as a tour host of the airplane. Come by and let me give you your group, your church organization, your school. Let me give you a tour of the airplane here at the Proud Bird. You will love it. Now come on out any Sunday after 12 o'clock and let me give you a tour here. Thank you so gentlemen so much. I'm so proud to be part of it. Oh, one more thing before I go. Be looking for our car show next year.
Oh yeah.
We're gonna do a car show right out here in the park, out here somewhere. For military vehicles. Right? Right? And classic car, you know. Hot rods will be out here. So it's gonna be a fundraiser for the museum and for my nonprofit school project. So we're gonna do a big thing next year. I put it out there, so now he heard me say that on video. He can't deny it.
And another point, the food is fantastic. I mean, come out here and experience your food, you're making me hungry.
Yeah. So anyway, that being said, thank you very much, gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
Reverend Prince, thank you very much. Be part of it. Reverend Jones.
Yeah, so happy to be with you. I can't thank you enough. Carrying on, he'll carry on that mighty legacy. And so that our ones are coming behind us and looking great models for the office. You're carrying on. So stay blessed. Look at your brother. Be
sure. I just got God told me to do it. Okay. Here we got Mr. Reginald Ballard. Reginald Ballard, aviator. And Reggie, tell me real quick. What did this day mean to you for history of
this day?
This day is for the 4:30 of March being to see here every day.
I think if you don't tell people what took place in the past, you wouldn't be in history. And I think to myself, being very important to my these pilots
with a keynote speaker today. He is a crowd.
they were some proud men. And behind the proud men, you had the proud ladies that was very important in this experience for the Tuskegee Airmen. So their girlfriends, wives, and then the ladies were like nurses and secretaries, part of them, but they didn't, but they wouldn't call the Tuskegee Airmen women. And they just completely skinned their day uniform, bandits, or they were nurses, secretaries, they were the administrators. And you can see all the guys were interacting with the ladies, you know. They were some good looking ladies and good looking men back in them days, you know. Look at that wave in the air. Wave. Yeah, they had good hair. All that gunk and duke hair cream. And these are moral classes. Okay? And anyway, in closing, I want to thank everybody for coming here to the Proud Bird. My name is Simeon Ginyard, Public Nation Chairperson for Los Angeles Chapter. On a historical day, March 22nd, 2018, we're honoring the Tuskegee Airmen Day. And thank you, Ms. Adam Burke, Assembly Woman Adam Burke. And thank you so much for being part of this historical program. So, that being said, right now, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you, and I'm out.
If I can see it, then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Yeah.